We have a nifty little session here about improving productivity with AI-powered test automation, and we have Matt's back to join us again, and we've got Igor, who's our Chief Product Officer at Parasoft, and we've got Adam, who's a Product Manager. So I'm going to jump away and let you guys do your thing.
Great.
Yeah, it's great to be here.
Yeah. Thanks, Igor and Adam. So we are going to do a quick closing, and for everybody on, thank you so much for staying on this long. Thank you for all of our speakers. Unbelievable content, some very, very smart people, and we really, really appreciate your time and so forth. But we have one more session that's really good. We're going to see some of the products everybody's been talking about in action, and I think that's super exciting. But before we get to that, and Adam's going to show us some of that and talk about that a little bit. Before we get to that, I've got a couple reminders for everyone. First of all, we will absolutely be sending out follow-up emails that will A, get you access to the on-demand webinar, B, will get you instructions how to get Gene Kim's slides, C, will remind you about the tech track we have in 2 weeks on the 17th. In addition, Arthur already mentioned we will have Q&A after this, so he's going to come back on after the demo, and there'll be Q&A, so as long as anybody wants to stay on for questions and answers to close the event. But I have one more announcement. So we did, I think many of you know, we were going to do a drawing for a winner for a $250 gift card for Amazon, and our winner is, drumroll, Yvonne R. is the winner. And so congratulations, Yvonne. So we'll be getting that back with you. In addition, we have several other winners of Gene Kim's book. So we were giving them away to some people that were registering and certain promotions. We also stated that we're going to be giving away additional signed copies of his book. So more drawing winners are coming. We'll be announcing those after the event for attendees for today, for attendees of the tech track. And people that respond to the survey will be sending out as well. So if you want to increase your odds, right, come back to the tech track and respond to the survey, and your odds will be increased of being selected to win a signed copy of Gene Kim's book. Okay, with that, there's a lot of questions that we could finish with. I could interview Igor on about today's session, about the content, but you know, I want to get to the point here. So there's two things. One, mainly what I want to ask Igor before we actually get to the demo, the cool demo that Adam's going to do, is about AI. I think we've kind of danced around it today. But we haven't really focused in on the role of AI in testing. And I know that you, A, are passionate about it, B, an expert, because I've heard you speak on this topic multiple times. But you're also going to be doing an in-depth session on AI at the Tech Track as our lead-off session in 2 weeks. So can you give the audience just a little bit of a flavor as to kind of a summary of what you're going to talk about in a couple of weeks and why they should come back and listen?
Well, we spent a lot of time today talking about test automation, right? And obviously, it's must. We move industry and everybody into directions of automate your testing to enable your developers, to enable your teams produce high quality products. But probably everybody on this call would agree that test automation comes with own challenges. So it's not trivial and easy task. Otherwise, everybody would be doing it for years and we will not have those discussions. And depends on what practices you're using for your testing, those challenges comes in different flavors. For example, if you focus on automations of your static analysis, your starting point can be easy. It's easy to automate, but then how you address thousands of violations which will be reported by the tools. If you talk about unit test creations, it's all about focus being kind of delivering your tests, applying the policy with every user story, but we know that 40% of efforts of development teams or even above can go into creation of unit tests and just maintenance. We can talk about UI testing, like probably the easiest practice to start working with, because there's a lot of tools which will just record and replay your UI, but then instabilities of those tests. So there's a lot of challenges, and each of them obviously create the opportunity for technology to step in and create or offer something that will help to automate and address those challenges in different flavors and different forms. So AI is very loaded term. Obviously core, it's like people are always talking about neural network, deep learning, and so on, but like classification techniques, even some heuristical algorithms, anything that makes system behave in smart way and take those difficult tasks or just routine tasks which manual users has to go through can be kind of treated as form of AI. So what I will do actually, I want to go through kind of testing pyramid, because that's the classic way to show you different testing practices. And we'll start with static analysis and unit tests and so on. I will want to talk about what are those challenges and what the business expectations from applying those practices, and how, for example, Parasoft technology using AI, using different techniques, helping to address and enable our developers or testers to actually move forward and apply them successfully into on the practice in production. So that will be the focus of sessions on 17th.
All right. So there we go. And I know that we're getting ready to wrap this up for the day. So where do you want to go from here?
So there was a couple of questions. I'm gonna go ahead and share my screen so that we have the thing, just so that people know, and then we'll go ahead and answer those questions. So we have a tech session coming up on the 17th. And it's a couple hours, 11 a.m. Eastern, so 8 a.m. Pacific, and the clock will have changed right then. So at 8 or 9 hours, depending on where you live, if you're still with us. But yeah, we'll have three different sessions there. So AI is a game changer for software testing, some things about unit testing, some things about continuous testing. So that's a great little thing, and you can bring your technical questions there. So I'll leave that up while we talk, but there was a few questions that I thought that we could handle here. And there was one here, Adam and Igor, that had kind of I was going to give it a simple answer, but then I thought maybe there's some context that I should take into account. They're asking, is there a specific framework recommended for Solanic healing to happen without much maintenance effort? So obviously we can do self-healing, but I didn't know if there were things that you would recommend in terms of constraints to...
Well, it's built on top of Selenium framework, right? And our current implementations support Java-based web driver for Selenium. So that's our primary focus today.
Okay. And let's see, somebody wants to hear from customers who've used BDD, but we can't really put customers online today, so we'll pass that one for the moment.
We do have... integration between Celotest and Cucumber. There's project on GitHub, I believe, and there's discussions on our forums. So you can always go to our forum.parasoft.com and basically find some reference about that.
Yeah, that's a good one, because there's been a couple of questions about it. Let's see. And if we had any of the other speakers that wanted to join at this point to answer a few questions, if you know, like Joe or Istiak, there's a couple of broad questions kind of related to some real things. But here's one. So Igor and Adam, thinking of shifting development process to TDD, how advantages will it in terms of automation testing use of Parasoft suite, right? So like, how well do we work with TDD and help people do TDD, right?
To me, TDD is a great techniques to involve less technical people, right? Kind of enable that automations to be created by more like business analysts. I personally, because I'm coming from technical background, strongly believe that the best automations can be achieved through more like technical involvement. So from that perspective, it depends on structure of the teams and who is actually responsible for writing those automation tests. But like I said, we do support TDD from that perspective. And what the benefits, it really will depend on how much emphasis on automations will be done by those high-level business people versus, for example, core engineers.
Okay. So we have another person asking about a demo. Here's one that anybody can answer. I don't know, Igor, if you have any answers from this, because it's more around like some of the customers, but like how long does it take for people to move from manual testing to, you know, this automated state that they've been talking about? And I don't know if you've, you know, thinking about some of our clients that you have some ideas.
It's a granular process, right? And there were some discussions about some questions were related today. How much you want to automate? Is it really 100% need to be done by for automations, or they could be split? So obviously, if the company in transitioning from purely manual test executions to start doing automations, I would probably focus on identify those primary use cases which you want to automate, primarily based on regression testing, right? The purpose of automation is that you'll catch any regression problems in the future. So yes, you might spend tons of time doing some edge case scenarios and try to automate those, but it probably will be not a good investment of your time if you'll start with those. So most probably you would want to focus on some smoke test automations, some high-level functionality check, just to be sure that your product with every build, nightly build, still stable and it's not falling apart, and try to catch those use cases as fast as you can. Now, as your team grows and you're investing more and more into your automation engineers, whether you hire, and again, depends on your strategy, you can go to the market and start hiring automation engineers, or you might decide to transform your manual testers into automations. Obviously, depending on your choice, the timeline, how long it will take you to get to more like automation state can be much longer. I believe different companies go through different experience. I would say it's probably might take multiple months, year, maybe more. It's again, depends on how fast you want to move and how big is your product and what technology you're using for automation.
And, you know, with things like Recorder in the interim, getting started with it makes it easier to create those initial tests and at least start the process. And then we also have some security testing features that we can put in as well that you can create from those tests immediately.
Yeah, cool.
So we can speed the process up quite a bit.
Right tools and right application of them can be definitely accelerator and enabler for moving from full manual testing to automations. That's for sure.
Yeah. So there's one more that I thought was really interesting, and it kind of came in late after some of the panels and after Gene, but Igor and maybe Adam, you've seen this too, and I know I've seen it a few times. Like what's the biggest mistake you see when people are trying to move towards CI/CD?
Ooh, that's a good one.
It's a great one, right?
Sometimes segmenting their teams too far from each other, like having one team really kind of get moving down that path and not the rest of the teams with them, so that team will end up siloed.
Well, another one you can think of, but again, it depends on the level of maturity. If your CI/CD build take 48 hours, right, as one of the examples mentioned today, then it probably is not very beneficial. Now, I can argue that it's better to have it running for 48 hours than not to have it all. But then your focus probably need to be on optimizations. So maybe run them in parallel, maybe use techniques such as, for example, test impact analysis to re-execute only subset of the test with every changes which you introduce into your build, just to validate that you don't have to run entire set of all the tests across your entire product every single time. So there's different ways how you can run it faster. The whole idea behind CI/CD, you run in every build and you try to provide feedback on the changes to your team as soon as possible. So they have ability to basically validate the changes, and if you need to be jump back and fix those problems, anything that will destabilize your products need to be addressed right away.
Yes, yes. And I think, you know, there was an interesting one that we ran short on time, that Gene and I had discussed our view of technical debt, which isn't a measure of metrics or complexity or static analysis failures. But if you read like the Unicorn Project, you'll see that the having the wrong infrastructure and having no infrastructure and no real good is the ultimate technical debt. It will kill you. Right. Mm-hmm. And I think the corollary to that is one that we've heard over and over in these summits over the years and with our clients, is that you can't simply automate what you're doing today. It's not going to scale, right? Like at some point you need to step back and say, what am I doing? Do I need simply just to automate the existing behaviors of these people? Or do I need to rethink my strategy? Do I need to find things that are earlier that I can do more often? Do I need to re-architect? Do I need different infrastructure? Do I need different tools? So it's not just, you know, record and playback and scale up, right? There's a lot more to CI/CD and thinking ahead of time, where do I want to go? How do I want to get there? And then planning it carefully is more important than scaling up automation first. You should do that last.
I agree.
That's true. And big part of CI/CD, it's all the dependency between your projects, right? Especially if you're talking about complicated multi-service architecture, where you kind of, are you going to rebuild all of them just because one service changed? Are you going to separate this and make some smart execution of your CI/CDs? And then automated deployment, obviously, giving access to your teams and push the products into production, first in test environment, doing validation verifications, and then pushing into productions. All of that need to be part of your kind of strategy when you think about CI/CD pipelines.
I remember one Java project I worked on years and years ago, and watching the dependencies, right? Like pulling in one thing and seeing how many other pieces it pulled in, right? And watching something, you think, okay, well, I pulled this in, it uses two or three other things. Next thing you know, you've got like, you know, 80% of the code in source control has been implicated for no good reason. So yeah, like paying attention to you know, interconnectedness, coupling, complexity, cohesion, like these are all super, super important. If you need everything to test something, it's probably a good candidate to stop and think about, is there a better way?
Yeah, for sure.
So I believe that's it. I do have one more slide. Let me just go ahead and slap it up. So, you know, we have a QR code here on the screen for everybody. So thank you so much for being with us this year. We're so happy to have you. The videos will all be online and available in the next day or two as we put stuff together, and you'll be able to watch them segment by segment on demand and share them with your friends, you know, let people know. If there's specific questions that you'd like answered, follow-ups that you want to have to it, please feel free to reach out to us. There's a URL there to request a demo. You can get the QR code and take a picture of it and do it. Send us email, info@parasoft.com. If you're trying to reach into the speakers, the same thing. If you'd love to share your story in the future, we'd be happy to hear from you. So let us know, and you can be a presenter, you can be part of a panel, we can do an interview, we can do little videos. Like sometimes we put short videos up on YouTube and let people share thoughts and ideas and little stories. So we're happy to hear from you as well. Thank you to all the panelists who spoke today. It's such fascinating stories, watching people, you know, succeed in such challenging conditions. And with that, don't forget to fill out the survey as well, because you get a chance to win an Amazon gift card. And with that, we'll say thank you, everybody, and have a great evening, day, morning, afternoon. Bye-bye.